हेलो सर, वेलकम टू द शो. गुड आफ्टरनून, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड, हाउ आर यू डूइंग?
ऑल वेल सर. सर, आवर व्यूअर्स आर प्रीटी एक्साइटेड टू नो योर व्यूज ऑन द बजट. यू नो, मार्केट्स हैव शोन सम पॉजिटिव साइंस एज फार इक्विटीज आर कंसर्न. डेट मार्केट्स आर स्टिल, यू नो, वर प्रोबब्ली होपिंग अ लिटिल मोर. सो ओवर टू यू सर, यू नो, योर व्यूज ऑन कमोडिटीज एंड करेंसी.
Yeah, surely. I think the entire country has been looking at the budget, and the outcome which has come yesterday is to be appreciated. I think Atmanirbhar is the concept that is to be followed by 130 billion people in the country, and I think the steps taken to grow the economy in a situation where we are already in a faltering global economy situation. So I think a lot of positive developments have been taken care in the budget. And to be talking precisely on the commodities part, I want to highlight a few things to mention here. I'm sure unlike equity and debt or any other sectoral specific development, which has been really, really robust in terms of growing the economy, inflation and all. Commodity point of view, I would say there has been few changes related to agriculture infrastructure development front, and also there has been some duty structure changes to the metals, especially to the precious metals, and some industrial metals also changed. There has been change in the duty structure. So that is what I want to emphasize here. So first of all, like in equity, we have security transaction tax. So is in commodity, we always have commodity transaction tax. Industry players had expected that the CTT probably could be removed from trading commodities derivatives. However, this has not come, but I would not say that it is highly discouraging, because I'm sure government must have thought of something to not remove the CTT from the commodity transaction tax from the commodity derivatives trade. So that continues to be there. However, if the CTT were removed, then probably even commodities market where it is standing today, probably it would have gone to a next level, or probably we would have seen more participation coming into commodities derivatives market. So I think we will be remain hopeful about CTT being taken out from the commodity derivatives market as part of as a cost. I think in coming years we should see some development coming in that. But besides that, we however have seen few changes in the custom duty, which may actually have affected commodity prices. I think that is very important that one should look at it. I'm sure we all know that from the commodity point of view, there are two most important commodities that we import into the country, that is gold and crude oil. And this budget has actually made some changes to the precious metal, that is gold and silver custom duty changes. So I think that is very important to understand. And to be very precise, as of yesterday, in India, the customs duty, that is import duty for gold, was set at 12.5%, and it's been there since 2019. The custom duty was at 12.5%. But in this budget, the FM has taken a call to rebalance the custom duty to the previous duty structure, and the base custom duty for gold and silver has actually reduced from 12.5% to today straight away to 7.5%, which is a big, big move as far as bullion or precious metal or let's say gold, silver import numbers are to be seen. However, although the custom duty has reduced from 12.5% to 7.5%, but it's now going to attract additional 2.5% agriculture infrastructure and development cess at the rate of 2.5%. So the net effect, if we will talk about the custom duty for gold, which was 12.5% at the net, has now actually come down to 10%. So I would like to talk a few seconds about the price action that we had seen yesterday. Typically, we are the net importer of gold into the country, whereas we never set the price of gold, and gold price in India are typically tracked globally. Global price standards. However, with the cut in the custom duty, the Indian gold prices, which were trading close to 49,000 to 50,000 rupees per 10 grams, actually declined almost 3%. That I would say on the close of the hour yesterday, it was down by around 1.5%. It's nothing but cut in the custom duty has had a reflect action on the price of gold prices in the domestic market, and that made the domestic gold prices to trade lower. So that is the immediate reaction that we got to see on the budget action on the custom duty reduction in the gold and silver. So especially we saw major action coming in gold, and that's how I said that gold prices will actually decline considerably. But I think going forward, one important factor that one needs to understand is that whenever in India gold prices declines considerably, then there is a huge amount of demand also crops in. And I think both retail and institutional demand will actually push again gold prices to move higher. So that could be a point that one should look at, even the good opportunity that we are buying the gold at a lower price with the king and the custom duty that government has taken a call yesterday. I think regarding to understand more on the duty structure calculation, if it is required, then probably we can take this up on a detailed note. Now, besides that, there has been a change in the agriculture sector, which is also very, very important today. I'm sure we are hearing a lot of news going today in the country, and I think it's very important to know what is the agriculture sector development that the finance minister has brought in. So basically, to tell you, the finance minister has assured that the government is committed to welfare of farmers, and the idea that MSP is to increase 1.5 times of the cost of cultivation. I think I would like to reiterate that the government has taken a decision that the MSP, the minimum support price, is to increase 1.5 times of the cost of cultivation. So when I say cost of cultivation is one of the component of MSP, and that the cost of cultivation of a commodity is to rise by 1.5%, and that's how it will reflect on the MSP. So end-to-end, if I would say, that is going to be beneficial for the farmers in the country, and that's definitely going to add a lot of value. So there are few commodities that I want to say, like in case of wheat, the total amount paid to farmers in the year 2013-14 was around 34,000 crores. If we look at in 2019-20, just 2 years ago, the government had announced to make payment to the wheat farmers in 1920 was 62,000 crores. In 2020-21, the amount that should be paid to farmers around 75,000 crores. And there has been a consistently increase in the expenditure towards the farmers in terms of supporting the farmers in the country. That I mentioned about wheat, if I talk about paddy, in the year 2013-14, the amount that was spent on the paddy farmers is 54,000 crores, and now it is more than 1,72,000 crores. So these numbers are eliminated from the budget speech report, and one can definitely refer to that. But what I'm trying to say here is that there has been a lot of positive development as far as commodity markets are concerned in terms of the value additions that has been given in the this year's budget. Last one point related to agriculture commodity that I want to tell you is that India is one of the largest producer of cotton in the world, and cotton farmers have seen a very stupendous increase in the amount that is paid. In 2013-14, a minimal incentive of 90 crores was given. Today, if I look at in 2020-21, it's around 25,000 crores. Besides that, in the interest of farmers, finance minister has also increased the import duty of cotton from 0% to straight 10%. It is nothing but just to attract the domestic farmers to encourage them to produce more cotton and to continue to enjoy the largest producer as well as exporter of cotton in the world. So these are the few changes that has brought in terms of agriculture commodities are concerned. I'm sure the detailed report talks about how the edible oil complex like crude palm oil or soya oil or sunflower oil, the import duty has been actually revised during this budget speech. So if we look at from the agriculture sector point of view, overall, I think it is an encouraging move that the finance minister has taken in the budget. So I think That is really encouraging. Last thing, the metal point, if I would say, the custom duty on copper scrap that we do import has actually reduced from 5% to 2.5%. So these are the few changes that has been brought into the budget this year. But precisely, I would say, gold is something to be looked at as an important event that has happened over yesterday.
Right.
Yes.
Right. One last comment from your end. What is the view on the currency, sir?
I think if you look at the overall budget, despite the current negative environment that is running across the world economy and in India also, I think a lot of boost is needed. And during this boost, we don't know how the inflation is going to play out in the next 6 months, 1 year, but I think it is to be perceived as one of the better year going to be for our country. Sure, and I think Indian rupee to look at on the stronger growth. But there are other ways to look at it also, whether the inflation, interest rate and other factors to look at it. But I think rupee seems to be now following the suit of economic revival and growth phase. So I think more of appreciation of rupee against the dollar is likely in the medium term.
But you know, if I just wanted to check from a perspective of the higher deficit number, it was expected that rupee will weaken, but is it that you know there is a lot of inflows of the fund and hence it is almost stable?
I think that can be one of the reasons, but I think if you look at the budget speech, what is mentioned there, if the economy has to revive, then our manufacturing sectors, the growth has to be actually doubled. So likewise, if you read the service sector also, I think it is to be shown a lot of positive developments. So with the economic growth, overall growth structure is to improve, I think deficit number, which is definitely come out to be more deficit size. But I think that is a long-term phenomenon to look at it. But in the quickly next 6 months, 8 months, I think a lot of development in the country will actually support our currency to get stronger against the dollar. And besides that, India is now discouraging a lot of import activity of various commodities and trying to support, let's say, from agriculture to non-agriculture or any other sectors where we do either export a lot or maybe we try to become a self-sufficient country here. So I think rupee should continue to appreciate. I don't see much of depreciation coming in going forward with the conferences here.
Thank you so much, sir, for your time. Really appreciate you taking out time for our viewers.
Sure. Thank you very much for
looking forward to more such conversations, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you very much.